Welcome back. I hope you're still not yet very overwhelmed with all the information we gave you at this moment. This is the last video of week 6. In this video, we will discuss the challenges we have about the topic of water resource management. Personally, I think it's fascinating to know that we need quite a lot of water just for food production. Water, which is not everywhere in the world, as you can see. So for now, we go back to the studio and I will have a short discussion with Professor Van der Giese about the challenges in the field of water resource management. For now, I would like to welcome Professor Van der Giese in Thank our you. Studio. Welcome. He is a leading professor in the water resource management. So looking at all the information you already presented, what will be the biggest challenge in water resource for the coming generation of students?
Yeah, I think we treated them already in the MOOC. I think the most important one is water for food. Where do we find all the water needed to produce our food? Like mm-hmm. you already said, we need much more than you think. 1 kilogram of food needs about 1,000 liters of water. And the other one is still how to supply water of sufficient quality and quantity to our cities that are ever growing. And these two challenges are really the challenges that students have to face and solve in the coming generation, let's say.
Okay. Well, thank you. Besides these challenges, you already named them, what will be the most important tools which we have at our disposal?
Yeah, there's many tools maybe, but the most important ones are also the ones that we talked about in the previous week. The first one is reservoirs. Not everybody's always very happy with reservoirs, but in order to make sure that there is always enough water in the right time, we probably need to build some more reservoirs in the future. And the other one is groundwater. That's also okay. It's also a resource that we have to be a little bit careful with because it's being overexploited in many places in the world already. So yes, it's there, but we have to be very careful not overexploiting our groundwater resources.
Okay. Well, thank you. Well, looking at all these tools, what is the scientific challenge herein?
Well, that's still quite large. There's two things that a colleague of mine, Professor Van der Zaag, always says, is that, for example, when it comes to food, the next green revolution, as mm-hmm. we call it, will be location-specific and knowledge-intensive. So we really have to know what we do where. There will be no silver bullet where you can just say, oh yeah, we have one solution for the whole world, it will fit everywhere. No, every location we'll have to manage in an optimal way, and for that we need a lot of knowledge. This knowledge will partially come from science, mm-hmm. Through better modeling, through better observation methods, maybe satellites, etc., 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 but it will also we need to take into local knowledge. So we have to go talk to farmers and make sure that these two sources of knowledge mm-hmm. will fit on each other so we can really optimize our food production and our water productivity.
So Professor Van der Giese is very clear about the challenges we are facing in providing water to the world. At the Water Resources Management Department at Delft University, researchers and students continuously developing new knowledge and sharing that knowledge with the rest of the world. Our student, Bernardine Tiethaten, is on a project in the West Bank in Palestine, where she advises the local authorities about ways to cope with scarcity of water.
Hi, I'm Bernardine. I'm doing my master's thesis for water resource management on the TU Delft. At the moment I'm in Palestine, and the subject of my thesis is rainwater harvesting and managed aquifer recharge for this area. So as you can see, there are lots of olive trees, but there are also lots of unused land. And the land, you can actually, it's a shame, the rain that falls on the unused land will run off and is unused in an area where water is really scarce and there's a shortage. So in order to assess if it's possible and which measures are actually implementable here, I'm using a model. And in the outcome, I will have a policy advice for policymakers in this area. It's a really, really interesting area, and I would recommend everybody to go on in these international experiences and see what you can do outside of your own little bubble.
This illustrates nicely that it's not just enough just to learn about water and its challenges, but we also need to apply the knowledge that we have. So if we all know about the challenges we are facing and we can apply our knowledge just in practice, then I think that we can make a difference. Well, this is it. I wish you good luck with the final exams. And thank you for participating in this MOOC. If you are interested in more MOOCs on water, Delft University of Technology has two other MOOCs you can participate in. Hopefully, we will meet again then.